Hi everyone. In today's video, we're going to talk about packages within Java. Packages are a way that you can better organize your code when you deal with large projects. When you have large code bases, it's imperative to be able to organize them in a convenient way, and packages are one way that the Java language does that. Let's pull up IntelliJ and take a look. Today's project we're going to call packages. So as we're used to, we create a project, and the project has this src, this source directory, and then it has our main class in here with our main method. That's all fine and dandy for a small project, such as a demonstration video like this, but when you have big projects, it really becomes a problem because you need to be able to organize your hundreds or thousands of classes into components or into various places. So to do that, you create packages. Creating a package is as simple as doing new package. And now the package naming convention is usually that it's lowercase, and you would often see it starts with the name of like a domain. So let's say I had a website called willtollefson.com. What I would want to do is I would make a package that was in the reverse. I would make com.willtollefson. All right, now we have our package here. Now what I can do is, just like I would do previously, is I can create a class in here. I'm going to call this my main class. And now we'll notice that it has this package declaration up front here. That wasn't in our main class, and the reason for that is because our main class is in something called an unnamed or a default package. I'll get into what that means here in a second. The point being, by default, we create a default or unnamed package. And when we have a package, we have to declare what package our class or interface is in. You'll notice if I comment out that code, I get an error, missing package statement. So I need to include the package statement. And then now I can do what I would normally do with my code. I can create instances of classes and things work as expected, right? Let's go ahead and test that. So now I have a main method in my com.willtollefson package within my main class method, and I want to import my original main class. You would think I could do something like that, right? Okay, so it's complaining. It can't resolve main. So, fun fact, the default package or the unnamed package, you should never use it other than for one-off cases for like a small program or a demonstration. Because as soon as you want to expand your code into using packages, you cannot import anything from the unnamed or default package into a class that is part of a package. So basically, the language designers added the concept of the default or unnamed package for convenience for when you are making small programs. That's all it should be used for. After that, you should be using packages as a way to organize your code. So since I can't use the main here, I'm going to go ahead and delete that line, and I'm going to go ahead and delete the main class that the IDE generated for me. And now I'm going to create a few additional classes. So let's make a new class called class 2. And now what happens if I want to make an instance of class 2? Is that going to work? All right, so that works. And the reason that works is because whenever you have classes within a package, the package is implicitly imported in the context of the package you're in. So what do I mean by that? You might recall, if you want to make a scanner, you have to use this import statement. And that's because the scanner class is part of a different package. The package is java.util. And again, you can see the naming convention here. So it's lowercase, and then you have these dots, which delimit the different sub-packages that are under the main package. So the main package is Java, and there's this util sub-package underneath the Java package. And then the last element, which is capitalized because class names are capitalized, is the name of the class within the java.util package. Now, one thing is this import makes it so that you don't have to use a fully qualified name. I actually don't technically need to use an import. I could just do this and type out the fully qualified name instead. You'll see that in code every once in a while when you have, let's say, names that conflict. but you don't often see people put out the fully qualified name. Oftentimes, developers will instead use the import statement because it cleans up the code a little bit, and you can go and look at what the scanner type is that you are importing pretty easily within something like an IDE. So I can see here that the scanner I've got is a java.util scanner. I don't need to spell out this is a java.util scanner every single time I'd want to make a scanner object, for example. So let's make a few more packages. So let's make a package within our existing one. We'll call it data. We'll make a class called DataDriver. And now let's see if DataDriver can get imported directly. So this time we can see that we had to use the import statement. Even though we are in what we'd consider the parent package, we still have to import the child packages that we are using here. So this import allows us to not have to use a fully qualified name. So again, to clarify, the imports are whenever we are importing something that is not in the current package. You don't get to use the thing you might normally expect, which would be inheritance of sub-packages. The sub-package concept is to continue to organize the code, but it doesn't directly translate to imports, if that makes sense. So another thing that's interesting about packages is that the package private access modifier starts making more sense. So that is when you don't add an access modifier. The default is package private. So let's say I make a class called class 3. And I want to make an instance of class 3. I can do that. And that works within the same package that I'm in. But now let's say I want to make a class 2. I have to import it, but it compiles because I am in a different package now. But I can still import it and this still compiles. Now instead, let's make this class 3. So now we would think that I should be able to import class 3, but that gives an error. Is not public, cannot be accessed from outside package. And that is because the default access modifier on a class is to be package private, which means that you can access the member within the contents of a package, but not outside of the package itself. Kind of interesting, huh? So one more case that I want to cover is when you have the same class name in different packages. So to demonstrate that, I'm going to go ahead and create one more package. I'm just going to call it test2. And then within test2, I'm going to create a class called duplicate class. And then I'm going to make another class within my com.willtollefson package, which we will also call duplicate class. And just to clean this up, I'll go ahead and delete these classes as well. And now we have duplicate class within com.willtollefson and duplicate class within test2. So now in our data driver, if I want to make a duplicate class, you can see that I could choose either one. In this case, I'm using the one in the com.willtollefson package. Now, what happens if I want to use the class within the test2 package? Well, my main option is I can use fully qualified names. So I could do test2, that duplicate class, and we see that this does compile. Alternatively, I could also update my import statement. And this works, except now we have a little bit of a weird scenario where we are importing the test2 duplicate class name, but then we're still using the fully qualified name here. So I could do com.willtollefson.duplicate class, and we'll see that that works as well. Really, the big thing you should be getting out of this is while code does compile when you have duplicate class names in different packages, it's usually best to avoid it. And the reason for that is because let's say that I had my own class name, which was called scanner or random within my package. If a developer is looking at that code, the first thing they're going to assume is that it's the JDK's scanner or random and not your own. And while you can go and you can look at the code and figure it out, it's not inherently obvious if you're scanning through the code quickly and you want to make your code easily readable. So that's one thing I do caution against. While the language does allow for it, I wouldn't necessarily recommend having duplicate class names across different packages. And that's an intro to packages within Java. The biggest thing to remember is that the unnamed or default package is there for convenience only. It doesn't get you very far when you want to write bigger Java applications, because by the time you move to actual packages, the default or unnamed package doesn't really get you anything. As soon as you realize you need to start scaling your application bigger, you should switch to packages as soon as possible. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something today. If you did, please do give the video a like. I'd really, really appreciate it. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a good rest of your day, and I hope to see you next time. Take care.